You're not rolling right now, are you? It's live?
Has grown his side hustle of cutting hair in his mom's garage.
How do you want kids to live without you? Let's be honest.
You have a quote that inspired you.
Man, my name is VicBlends.
Don't let what you're good at define who you are. Who are you if you can't do what you're good at?
I would be lying to you if I told you I'm the most confident person. Everywhere that I go and every room that I step into, I feel like I'm the one. I mean, that's just not reality. And sometimes it looks like that from the outside in, but I mean, I step into rooms sometimes and I feel like a shadow. Other times I feel like a star. You know, you gotta remind yourself of that.
Yeah, I'm him.
You're him, bro. As soon as you wake up, I'm him. In the mirror, every morning.
You start saying that every day when I wake up.
Just growing up and not having a mirror image for me to look up to. You know, I didn't have anybody that was 18, 19, 20 who was just an inspiration, who would show us like how to be successful in a real way. Not to pop pills, not to do drugs, not to chase women, not to do any of that. But I just reminded myself that most people feel awkward already anyways. So that same feeling that you share is like the other person shares that too. And all it takes is somebody to break the plane. Who's just gonna do it their way? You know, instead of waiting for somebody to come save me, I had to like remind myself that nobody's ever gonna come save me. You know, like if I wanted to be that change, I gotta wake up and be it every day. When I got to Atlanta, it was just like trying to expand my horizon, like get opportunity to work with different people, work with different entertainers and athletes. I'm trying to like cut everybody, man. Just like be the best barber in the world was like the focus. And then I came to Atlanta and I did that, man. I started getting hella successful as far as barbering goes. I'm making tons of money. Like, everything's exactly what I wanted.
The cut is cool, man, but it's just a vehicle, bro, to talk about shit that we feel like nobody else goes through.
It wasn't supposed to be a real job. I was never supposed to be here still with Clippers. Like, I picked up Clippers because I thought I was going to go to college, and this is what I was going to do to make $5 to $10 in the dorms. You know, I was just, like, scared. Like, man, is this good enough for me? Like, is this enough? You know, I ain't know if it would be enough for me. I ain't know what I was really going to want for my life, and you know, I'm not saying I was like ashamed to be a barber, like to grow up to be that, but I just didn't know what it really meant.
Passion is like shit that we love. It's like skateboard, it's love you got from the skateboard, bro. But like purpose is like why you're here doing that shit. And a lot of people can never like, you gotta really find the two. They can work well together, but you find purpose, bro, it's like that shit gets so clear. And when I found that shit, bro, everything changed. And I decided like start giving out free cuts on the streets.
I always hear stuff, it inspires me.
That means a lot.
Of course, yeah, bro, absolutely.
I see you all the time on TikTok.
Thank you for that, bro. I appreciate that support.
Sean, Q, and G from Barber Kings. I couldn't be here without them. Like, I feel like I couldn't be here as a person without them. Not as a barber. I was 3 months into cutting hair. I couldn't even do a fade. And they were doing Cut My City, which is a give back event where they would give out free haircuts to the kids going back to school. And, you know, I was joking to them because I just started cutting. And, you know, they're like, oh, yeah, Vic's starting to learn how to cut hair. And they proud of me, you know, but I'm just like joking and I'm like, hey man, you gonna let me come to Cut My City? And they were like, yeah, come on. I was like, for real? I ain't got no license. Like, you sure? Like, I just started. And Sean was like, yo, come on. You know, and you know, I thank God I got to have, you know, more mature conversation with him now and try to like understand like why did y'all do that for me? And you know, he told me it's not about if you could cut hair or not. Like, if you're ready, you're ready. And I didn't even know what that meant at the time until I saw, you know, the responsibility God gave me now for my community. And that just came through them.
We want things to play off of. We'll be cutting equipment to the new basketball.
21-year-old celebrity barber Victor Montanez holding a Christmas community give back.
I'm still feeling like there's something I gotta feel right here.
Why after 3 years do you feel like it's time to change?
We've seen some incredible growth on your platform, but where do you want to grow next?
What is your name?
What do you want to be when you grow up?
What else I got to offer to the world?
My name
Brody.
I'm a sports executive.
You know, I let the noise stop. They told me to shut up and keep cutting hair.
I want to like be a scientist.
And they
God showed me, like, man, if you can't do that, what you gonna do?
Anytime you gotta go through something that's a little hard, God, I want to thank you for blessing you, the time that you're giving you today to be here. The reward can be that much better.
I went back to what I knew I was always put on this earth to do, and I wanted to do with my voice.
You know the only way you change a rock is if you break a rock.
I want to thank you for the help that you left me, God.
Man, you fit anywhere where you water.
Hard times, God, I want to thank you for the good times.
The only way that rock fits into any place it wants to be is if you break that shit.
I want to thank you for the blessing of being here, God.
And if I gotta be broken to be there, I don't want to be there.
Also known as the VicBlends, and I would say now I'm a multi-hyphenated person.
Hit it.
Do you like cutting a kid that knows who you are or doesn't know who you are?
It really doesn't even matter, whoever. If they know me for sure, because I'm sure they got something they want to ask me, but
is there a part in your heart?
Yeah, I like cutting honest strangers too at the same time.
You think this shirt means a lot to the owner?
Maybe like 50?
I gave you 50 bucks, did it? I remember the first name one of the homies gave me was Clips the Barber, but spelled like K-L-I-P-Z-Z. Like it was like a Modern Warfare like username, like a Call of Duty username.
I was 3 months into cutting hair, I couldn't even do a fade.
I just want an honest interaction. Sometimes somebody know like where it's going or who's gonna see it. They start, you know, they say things they wanna say and stuff, but
right,
I just
right.
want like real honest conversation. That's all I ever look for.
What's the purpose of the chair?
I make content, I give people free haircuts.
Okay.
Yeah, so I'm about to go out and just bless people with some cuts, man. So.
Okay.
I like the hug after.
Bro, man, for sure.
Let's start with y'all. Man, we gotta get a picture before you leave, bro.
Yeah,
we gotta get a picture before you leave, bro.
Like the hug after. It's a lot. Like when the camera like goes down and we're like, yo, thank you, and like I get that hug off camera.
Man, sure. For real, bro.
Yeah, I swear, I don't usually like, you walk right past anybody. Like, yeah. I see you, I was like, yeah, I gotta
say something. Nah, he literally was popped out the window.
Bro, yeah, thank you so much for that, bro.
I know you're genuine, I can really see you. Like.
Appreciate y'all trusting me, man, for real. It means a lot.
Yeah, it's like, yeah, I love that.